exhibition of the season. South defeated Daniel Boone 41-16 to move their record to 1-2. South runs a spread offense and are led by quarterback Heath Hayden, who was 10 for 20 last week, no interceptions and 3 touchdowns. One of those touchdowns was a 21-yard pass to wideout Drew Shanks. Hayden's other 2 touchdowns came on a 1-yard run and a 74-yard run. Running back Jordan Castle had touchdown runs of 15 yards and 8 yards. The Rebels also had a kickoff return of 93 yards for Cody Medlin. The Blue Devils used a balanced attack last week to defeat Tazewell. Quarterback Nick Bowen was 7 for 8 with 1 interception and 2 touchdowns for 195 yards. One of those touchdowns was an 83-yard pass to Corey Franklin. The Blue Devils also rushed for 157 yards and 4 touchdowns. One of those was a 55-yard run by Joseph Fun. Mark, both these teams had great offensive outbursts last week, so it may come down to which team plays the best defense tonight.
Well, no question that, you've got two pretty good football teams getting ready to go at each other. Last year, we hosted the Rebels, and we treated them very kindly, Larry. We turned the ball over 3 times, I think, in the first quarter, and allowed them to get a big lead on us, and we couldn't recover from that. But it's a different season. Both these teams have a loss, and of course, South with a couple, but each, like you said, got big wins last week, and this should be an interesting game. Without question, should be an interesting game here tonight before we start our district schedule next week. A little rain here earlier, but looks like that has stopped, and we'll take a break right here, and we'll come back with the starting lineups and opening kickoff in 3 minutes.
Starting lineups for tonight's game for the visiting Blue Devils. At wide receiver will be number 42, Montana Morris. At left tackle will be number 70, Daniel McMurray. Left guard, number 73, Cody Vaughn. Center will be number 55, Austin Reed. Right guard will be number 54, Cody Davidson. Right tackle, number 68, Austin Dockery. Tight end will be number 8, Michael Kelton. The blocking back or H-back will be number 44, Seth Clark. Tailback will be Dusty Clark, number 15. Fullback, number 31, Joseph Vaughn. And quarterback will be number 10, Nick Bowen. For the homestanding Sullivan South Rebels, the tackles will be number 69, C.J. Morlock, 6'0", 190 junior. At the other tackle will be number 74, Austin Hyder, 6'5", 285-pound senior. The guards will be number 68, Matt Wilkerson, 5'10", 230 senior. And Logan Culberson, 6'3", 285-pound sophomore, number 75. Center will be number 65, Nick Soap, 6'1", 195 senior. They use 3 wideouts. One of them will be number 35, Drew Shanks, 5'10", 155-pound senior. And number 36, A.J. Rowland, 5'8", 165-pound senior. The other wideout will be number 30, Paul Wagner, 6'0", 160-pound junior. Tight end will be J.C. Garvin, 6'3", 200-pound junior. Quarterback will be Heath Hayden, number 12, 6'1", 175-pound senior. And Jordan Castle, the running back, number 1, 5'11", 190-pound senior.
Sullivan South wins the toss. They defer their choice to the second half, so Heath City will receive the opening kickoff here tonight.
Back deep for the Blue Devils to receive on the far side will be number 31, Joseph Fine, and on the near side will be 42, Montana Morris, as Adam Penaves will kick off for South.
Mesquite City in their road white, South in the home powder blue jerseys with gray pants.
And Penaves approaches the ball at the 40, hits a high end over end kick, it's short. And fielded at the 12-yard line by Morris, who comes up to the 20, 25, and driven down at about the 28-yard line. So the Blue Devils will take over at their own 28, first and 10. Under center will be Seth will be Nick Bowen. See what kind of we have an official's timeout here for a second.
And what's the hold up here?
Not really sure unless they're moving the players back on the
they're
bringing them back. Clock start. Yep, clock started.
Well, not sure. I've sent both teams to the maybe the change or not.
Could be it.
Are they checking on somebody down here?
Well, that does look like it's. I don't think it's a player.
No, I think maybe might be a chain problem actually.
It looks like they're working on the chains.
Yeah. Well, we'll take a break right here. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
Blue Devils have it on their own 29, first and 10, as it appeared to be one of the chain crew members had been injured a little bit, but he got up, seems to be okay. Blue Devils in a power eye as Bowen rolls to his right, throws the pass complete across the 30 to about the 32. Small gain on the play. Pass complete that time to Collier of Gate City.
Gain of about 3.
Michael Collier getting a little bit more playing time as every week goes along. He's really a backup quarterback, but they've been running him a lot of receiver, haven't they?
It's been hard for him to get a whole lot of playing time since he's a freshman. That's only the third game of the year.
Yeah, true. Blue Devils in a wishbone this time, two tight end. They hand off to the right halfback out of that formation. He gets across the 35 up to about the 37.
About a yard that shy.
So that was Vaughn on the carry that time by Gate City. We'll spring up third down, and Mark said about a yard, and that looks to be about right.
Maybe yard and a half.
Yeah, long yard. They started right on the 29, but that, I believe you're pretty much correct on that. Looks like it's spotted at the 28. So.
Well, if we can pick up 6 feet, we'll have a first down.
True.
Sounds easy.
Devils with 3 wide outs to the left as Bowen looks, throws a pass that is complete across the 40 to the 43. That pass complete to Dusty Clark.
Tell you one thing, ain't not a whole lot of times that we've got a 3rd and 1 and throw it, do we? It doesn't happen.
Not very many times in Blue Devil history will you see that, will you?
And that's a good thing. It makes people think.
All this passing will somewhere along the line open up your running game.
Yes, it will.
Blue Devils this time to full house, 2 tight end. As they put Clark in motion, they hand off to Vaughn out of the fullback spot, and he gets across the 45 to about the 46-yard line. That's a gain of about 3 on the play, maybe 4. It's going to bring up 2nd down and 6 with 9:50 to go here in the first quarter, no score. Blue Devils have it on their own 47. This time the Blue Devils go to an off-balance wishbone. They hand to Vaughn. He gets across midfield down to the 49 of the south. We're getting about 3 yards a clip, Mark, on every running play, seems like.
Yeah. Had some light rain here earlier. Field's in great shape.
Blue Devils went with a unbalanced line that time. It actually shifted the wing on the in the wishbone a little bit. If you're looking at it, off kilter, hand off to Dusty Clark around the end. He's tripped up, but he may very well have his first down. Tripped up at about the 46. Needed to make the 47, it looks like.
That's the first down.
Yeah. 1st and 10 for Gate City at the Solon South 40. Well, we'll call it the 46-yard line. Devils now have strung 2 first downs together in this drive. This time the Devils is with a wing back, 2-back set. Hand off to Vaughn, running off the left side. Fights, breaks out. No, that's not Vaughn on the carry. That's
Seaver Elliott
on the carry. And he breaks tackles and get in across the 40 down to about the 36, and that should be close to another first down.
Yeah, that's another first down. But what are the referees conferring? Is there a flag?
I don't see a flag. I think they're trying to decide whether to bring a change in or not.
Well, they're talking to, but they're talking to Gate City, but the and the official's giving a signal. Just not sure what he. Well, let's see.
With no penalty. The ball's going to be spotted right there. The sign is to the far side. I don't know either.
No. Well, anyway.
First and 10 for the Blue Devils, the south 36-yard line.
That's a sign we need. It's first down.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. Blue Devils going to spread offense this time with two wideouts to each side. Now they put the wing back on the right side in motion. And Blue Devils may be in a motion herself. Looks like we're going to have an illegal procedure called against Gate City.
Yeah, that's can't stop your sale.
Tyler Bird was a wingback at that time on the right side. It went in motion. I got to believe it was an offensive lineman may have moved a little bit.
Yeah, I do
on
too. It wasn't Bird when he came in motion. It wasn't on him. Maybe something on the right side of the line.
So that makes it first and 15 now, the ball back at the 41-yard line of South. Devils go with, looks a little bit like a, as pass is going to be thrown downfield and intercepted by South. As Bowen rolled to his left, really didn't get his shoulder squared, threw it up, and South intercepted the ball at their own 14-yard line.
Yeah, you're going to throw that in the bushes.
Yeah, really, that man was covered. You got to throw that one away.
Yep.
So, after a good drive and a 5-yard penalty, now an interception stops it. The drive at the south 14-yard line. 7:56 to go here, first quarter. Hayden with two backs in their spread offense. Hand off this time to number 44 out of the backfield. And that is Brent Hubbard, the main running back. Normally for South, when they use a one back set, is number one, Jordan Castle. But Hubbard that time was in the backfield. Stop is for maybe a yard gain on the play. Brings up second down and 9. As again, Hubbard along with Castle in the backfield with Hayden. Two wideouts to the right, one to the left. Hayden throws a long pass down the field that is going to be almost intercepted by Gate City. Broken up though. Franklin that time on the coverage.
Yes, it was.
For the Blue Devils. Played the ball all the way, I thought. Did a good job. 7:01 to go first quarter. No score. Brings up third down and 9 for the Rebels of Sullivan South. You know, Mark Hayden, I believe, got his first start last year when they played us over there,
yes.
Did he not?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he did. I mean, I know he started the game, played the game as the starter was injured.
Third and 9 for the Rebels. Two wideouts to the left, one to the right. Hayden fakes a handoff. Now gets some pressure, now breaks containment. Gets across the 20, the 25, the 30, and finally knocked out of bounds. One thing about Hayden, he's as good a runner as he is passer.
We lost containment on him and let him out of there.
Brings it all the way up to the south 44. You know, that's one thing about this spread offense. When you got wide outs, a couple of lead side, you've got the defense spread out all over the field also. So South has it first and 10 at their own 44-yard line. Two wideouts to the left again, one to the right. Hayden gets a snap, Drops straight back, looks for a screen, has it set up well.
Yep.
Pass complete to Castle across midfield. 45 gets a block on the corner. Finally tackled at about the 45 of Gate City. It should be enough for a first down. It's going to be almost, it's a 44 of Gate City. So South moving right on down the field also.
Yeah, they had the perfect call against our, we just didn't recognize that.
And out this time is fake to Hubbard, given to Castle. He's across the 30, down to the 25, inside the Blue Devil 20, and finally knocked down at the 15-yard line of Gate City. So right now, the defense for Gate City is struggling, trying to stop Sullivan South. South will have it first and 10 at the 15-yard line of Gate City. Hayden, first and 10, two backs again in the back there. Hands off to Castle again, this time running right. He gets stopped short of the 10 at about the 12-yard line. Gain of 3 on the play. Bring up second down and 7 for the Rebel. You know, if you run this spread, Mark, you've got to have a quarterback that not only throw it, but be able to run. He's the most important guy in that whole offense, really. Hayden fakes. This time he faked the Castle and handed out to Hubbard, and the Blue Devils ready for it this time. No gain.
Seth Clark, a couple others in on that.
So that's going to bring up third down and 7. With 5:18 to go, first quarter, no score, but South on the Blue Devil 12-yard line. Really on the 13. This time South sends two wideouts to each side. Castle the only back in the backfield with Hayden. Wing back on the left goes in motion. Hayden keeps it, cuts around the corner, gets to the 10, walks all the way into the end zone for a touchdown. So a 13-yard touchdown by Hayden puts South on top, 6-0.
Well, they made that look pretty easy.
Moved it down the field pretty good.
Yep. Touchdown off turnover, too. Kick is up.
Kicks up and good by Benavis.
So, with 4:44 to go here in the first quarter, it's Sullivan's now 7, Gate City nothing.
Benavides ready to kick out from his own 40. Vaughn on the far side, Montana Morris on this side. And the kick is a low line drive that is fielded by Nutback at the 20, 25, 30, gets a hole. Gets up across the 35. And pretty good field position on that carry that time for the Blue Devils.
Micah
Bledsoe, number 30. So the Blue Devils will start out first and 10 on their own, looks like their own 33. South on top, scored with 4:44 to go in the first quarter. Extra point good, South leads 7-0. Devils with a wing back on the left side, split backs in the backfield. They hand off to Vaughn running from the right halfback spot across the 40 to about the 42. About a 4 or 5 yard gain on the play. Spotted close to the, well, it's right on the 42, so it's going to be second down and about, we'll call it 6. It's about 5.5. Ball at the south 42 yard line. Blue Devils need to make the 48 for a first down. And out to Vaughn running out of the left tight back spot. He gets across the 45. going to bring up third down and short for Gate City. They spot it just at about the 46. Devils need to make the, looks like about the 48. Be third down and two. Blue Devils this time go full house and two tight end. They hand off to Clark, and he stood up after a gain of maybe a yard. They stood Dusty up after he got to the 47, so Gate City is going to have to punt here. Doing a punting for Gate City is going to be Miller. Derek Miller, back deep for South is I think Paul Wagner. High snap, good punt. Wagner fumbles the ball, it's loose on the ground. They still scramble after it. And let's see what the sign. Gate City has recovered inside the 20-yard line of Sullivan South. So the Blue Devils get a break.
Got to take advantage of it. We give them one, and now they give us one, and we've got to finish it. Good high punt. Almost might have come down a little bit as a knuckleball. You know, it didn't turn over, but.
Ball will be spotted on South's 19-yard line. Devils this time look to be in a wishbone with an unbalanced line, strong side to the left. One wide out to the left side. As they pitch it to Vaughn, he cuts it back inside and gets down to about the 15-yard line, a gain of maybe three on the play. Finn and Worley spotted. Spotted just short of the 15, so a gain of three brings up second down to seven for the Blue Devils. You know, Mark, we gave them some gifts last year over there in the first quarter.
Right. Well, you know, they've given us one here. We take advantage of it.
Second down and seven for the Blue Devils at the 16-yard line of Sullivan South. Minute 57 to go. First quarter, South on top, 7-0. We put the wing back in motion from the right side, and he's tripped up in the backfield and didn't get back to the line of scrimmage. That's Tyler Bird. South got in the backfield and brought Bird down a yard short of the line of scrimmage. So it's going to bring up a long third down, third and eight now.
Might have been a little hesitation there just for a split second.
But they also had some, you know, got some penetration too. I keep bumping my cameraman here to my left.
Well, it's we've got such abundant room to work.
Devils go shotgun. Handed off to Vaughn, running down the right, halfback spot. He struggles across the 15 down to the 14. Devils need to get it down to the 9 for a first down. So let's see what Coach Housewright's call is here. Spotted on the hash mark to the left. And Gate City is going to send in Logan Bird to attempt the field goal.
Should be about 32 yards on the attempt.
Well, this will be his first attempt this year, right?
Actually, 31 yards.
Yeah, 31.
I'll assure you he's got plenty of leg to get it there.
Snap is good. Placement looks good. Bird gets it up, and the kick is no good. Off to the right, so Blue Devils shoot another blank. South holds 27 seconds left. The first quarter, South still on top 7-0.
Yeah, missed that one wide to the right. Just pushed it out a little bit.
It's hitting them. We were looking there in warm-ups, hitting them from 42, wasn't it? 52?
Yeah. Just missed that. That's all right.
South with two wide outs to the left, one to the right. Two backs in the backfield. Castle and Hubbard. Hayden, the quarterback. Looks over the Blue Devil defense, drops straight back, throws a look-in pass that is complete to about the 28-yard line. 27-yard line. Good gain on the play. About 8 yard, an 8 yard pass going to bring up second down and two.
And that'll bring the end of the first quarter here at Sullivan South. We'll tell you after one quarter of play, it's the Rebels 7 and the Blue Devils nothing.
South, second down and two at their own 27-yard line. Hayden waiting on the snap, gets it, drops straight back, looks, now takes off running and is brought down right at the marker, maybe just a little short. Needed to get it to the 30, stopped at about the 29 and a half.
Yeah, going to be about a foot short. It looks like the ball's got to get just to the 30.
So it's going to be third down and inches for South with 11:32 to go in the second quarter. South on top by a score of 7-0. South will see if they go under center for the first time tonight. Looks like they're having problems on getting lined up. As now we have a penalty.
It's going to be third and five now.
Looks like too much time, maybe. Let's see if that's a call on South.
No, I believe it must have had a lineman. Somebody must have moved inside.
It is an illegal procedure call. The official is giving his signs to the home side, so that'll bring up third down and about 5.5 for our South. Ball now back just short of the 25. That's Hayden back in the shotgun. Fakes, keeps himself, and the Blue Devils hit him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
Yeah, we saw that one about two or three times the first go-round and stopped him that time. So that penalty, a huge penalty for South. Big break for Gate City.
On the tackle that time, Seth Clark, along with Logan Russell, I believe. South back in punt formation. Gets off a knuckleball punt that Vaughn asked for and makes a fire catch at his own 45-yard line.
So the Blue Devils have good field position here for the first series of the second quarter, trailing 7-0, 10:27 to go here in the first half.
One into the ball game for Gate City is going to be Micah Bledsoe in the backfield. See who he's replacing. Maybe Clark.
I would think probably Seth.
Blue Devils hand it off to Dusty Clark, running right, gets around the corner and picks up about 3 yards. Knocked out of bounds just short of midfield, maybe at the 49. Yeah, Bledsoe in for Seth Clark in that H-back spot. Devils with a tight end to the left side. Bledsoe goes in motion, turns the corner left, hand off to Vaughn, running left, gets across the 40, spins inside the 35, down to the 20, breaks the tackle. He's going to go all the way for a Blue Devil touchdown. No flag, it's a 49-yard touchdown, or a 51-yard touchdown by Joseph Vaughn.
Yeah, Bledsoe went motion there. He got a pretty decent block there, and that let Vaughn cut it back against the green and then made a good move when he had one man to beat. Joseph carries it on into the end zone. The Blue Devils now with a chance to tie. They'll have Logan Bird on to kick the extra point. Russell snap. Franklin will hold.
Blue Devils try to get this extra point to tie it up here. Looks like a good snap. And the kick looks like it's right through the middle, and it is. So Bird's extra point is good. Gate City and South tied at 7-7. Nick Bowen about ready to kick off on the far side, number 84, Cody Medlin, who had 93-yard kickoff return last week, I believe. Your side is going to be Paul Wagner. As Bowen's kick is high and short, going to be fielded at the 19. And the Blue Devils will bring him down short of the 30 at about the 27-yard line.
Nick didn't quite catch all that one, did he?
No, and I believe he might have been kicking away from him.
Of course, that might have been planned that way, too.
Jake Weaver was the man to return to the kickoff. So South will take over in this tie game at their own 27-yard line. Hayden still with Hubbard on his right, Castle on his left, two wideouts to the right this time, one to the left. Hayden gets a snap, hands off to Hubbard out of the right back spot. He gets across the 30 up close to the 34, good gain on first down for South.
Yep, a little too much on first down there, about 7 yards.
Mm-hmm. It'll be second down and 3 for South.
I guess we have to widen a little bit, Larry, to keep Hayden from running the corner, and then that'll make us a little softer. We got to give up something somewhere.
Yep, you're right, Mom. Second down and a long 3 as Hayden fakes this time to Hubbard, hands off to Castle, who breaks it into the open to midfield, down in the Blue Devil territory to 49. As they fake to Hubbard, pull it back and hand it off to Castle and get a big run. So they're able to run right now in the middle of our defense. The ball is to Gate City, 49. First and 10 for Sullivan South. Two wide outs to the right this time. Hayden gets a snap, fakes, now keeps it himself and looking for a place to run. Has some blocking on the corner. Is that the 45, the 40, breaks the tackle, and will probably go all the way. I don't see a flag, do you?
No.
So that's a 49-yard touchdown by Heath Hayden.
It looked to me like Seth Clark got blocked from the back bad, but still yet, we had him stopped, Larry, and just didn't get him on the ground. We had him 2 or 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage. So South jumps out on top, 13-7, with 8:10 to go now in the first half.
Snap a little high, the kick is up, and the kick is good. So South goes on top of Gate City by a score of 14-7. South about ready to kick off to the Blue Devil. As Moore kicks all the extra points, it looks like that Adam Benavides is the kickoff artist. Back deep for the Blue Devils, near side, Joseph Fine, far side, Montana Moore. It's a whistle, and Benavides approaches the kick, hits it from a 40, high end-over-end kick. It is going to go out of bounds at about the 13-14-yard line, but that'll put the ball on what, the 40 in high school or 35?
35, I believe. I know it's 40 in college.
But I think it's 35 in high school.
Yeah.
It's going to be spotted on the 35. So the Blue Devils have to see if they can counter that touchdown of South. Devils with two wideouts to the right side, one to the left. Blue Devils in a kind of a spread offense themselves with, as the officials now are going to move the ball to the hash mark to the far side of the field. Split backs in the backfield along with Bowen. As Bowen looks, throws a little flyer pass out intended for Dusty Clark, led him too much, pass incomplete. Now, that play had a chance of getting a few yards, but you got to hit it. Clock stopped with 8:05 to go in the first half. He's second down and 10 for Gateshead. Second and 10 from the Blue Devil 35. Devils with a wing back. This time they hand off to Clark running right. Cuts it inside around the right end. Gets up to the 40, gains about 5. Going to bring up third down and 5 for Gate City. Dusty Clark gives you one thing out of that backfield. Gives you speed.
Got a little step with him still, not 100% yet, but looking quite a bit better.
Blue Devils third and 5 at their own 40, need to get it to the 45. Wing back on the right side, setbacks. Now the wing back goes in motion. That was Franklin, and a handoff was to Bond, and he's hit behind the line of scrimmage for about a yard loss. So Blue Devils with a 4th and 6 here will have to punt. We didn't get the end on that side block.
Yeah, it's the same play that Vaughn scored on.
South with only one deep. I think it's a Wagner. As we get a low snap back to our punter, but he gets off an end-over-end punt that's going to hit at about the 25. Wagner goes back inside the 20 and fields it at the 18 and tackled at the 25.
So that worked out pretty good for the Blue Devils after.
They had to do a good job fielding the snapper.
Yeah. Well, we've got to find a way to keep them from gashing, so just,
yeah.
We've stopped the run a time or two, but for the most part, they've been able to run it at will.
Yeah, they've done better running the ball than they have throwing the ball, really.
Well, no need to throw it if you can run it.
That's exactly right. Two wideouts to the left for South. One to the right. Hayden with those two backs in the backfield. Fakes, keeps himself, cuts it around the left end, and is dropped after a gain of maybe 2.
Miller and Dusty Clark on the stop.
It's going to bring up second down and 8 for South. Dusty in on defense that time. Yeah, he's at the safety spot, isn't he?
Uh-huh.
First time this year I believe he's played any defense.
Play or two, and that's been about it.
This time they put their left back in motion as Hayden rolls to his right. And he gets a good block on the corner, cuts it upfield, and other than a tackle by Dusty Clark,
they're going to call him for holding this time.
They have a flag, as Mark said. So that good block on the corner over there was probably a hold.
Well, it rivaled what I thought was a block in the back there. On the other touchdown run.
The officials will mark out the holding from the spot of the hole.
They're about second and 11 when they spot it.
Yeah, you're exactly on the money, sir. Second down and 11. Ball spotted inside the 25 at the 24. Blue Devils could use a turnover here. As Hayden, this time with wideouts to the left, one to the right, pretty much their set offense. They just swap those wideouts from one side to the other, and this time only one back. And Hayden, on a little counter move, cut it back, gets a yard or two before he's driven back by Dusty Clark.
Yeah. Actually, really didn't gain anything.
No, nothing at all.
Yeah, Clark's a run stopper, boys, I'm telling you.
Yep.
We miss him badly when he's not in there.
Well, I'll tell you another thing he does, Mark. He's a good tackler. He wraps up on his tackle.
That's what I mean. He's a run stopper.
So it's third and still 11 for South. One back in the backfield. Devils with two safeties as Hayden drops straight back, looks, gets some pressure, now rolls to his right, gets some more pressure, and he's hit, but he breaks that containment. Now back to the left again as he's going to be stopped short of the first down finally at about the 30-yard line. No flags on this play. A lot of running by Hayden, and really he gained about 7 yards on the thing, but not a first down.
Tazewell leads 11 and 17-7. First half. So Tazewell got on the scoreboard this year. So they shut out in their first two games.
Fourth and five for Sullivan South with 4:08 to go here. First half, they're on top of Gate City 14-7. High snap. Punter, Gate City goes for the block. Punt is kind of off the side of his foot. Takes a Blue Devil bounce back to midfield, and Gate City will take over with the nose of the football right at on the 50s.
3 minutes, 50 seconds to go here in the first half. Need to take this down and get this thing tied up here at halftime.
Blue Devils have opened up their offense a little bit more than we're normally used to seeing a Gate City team do in the last two games, really. Like they're having problems getting a line on some of this. So wing back on the left side goes in motion. Bowen looks, throws a pass that is intercepted.
Nope.
No, they say it hit the ground. It was deflected and I thought almost intercepted by South. Pass intended for Clark. Stops the clock with 3:40 to go in the first half. South on top, 14-7. Blue Devils with the ball just nose on the 50. South has playing a seven-man line. Fumble snap. Bowen picks it up, cuts around the corner. Midfield, 45, 40.
Got a block.
Makes a move, gets down inside the 30 before he's driven out of bounds.
Well, got a break. Drops it, but now we got a block from somebody on the corner. I don't know who it was, but whoever threw the block got Bowen another 10, 12 yards. Great block.
The first and 10 for the Blue Devils at the, I think about the 27 of South. So the Blue Devils in good shape here to good field position with a chance to put a tying score on the board before halftime. Full house this time. Two tight ends for Gate City. Unbalanced line, strong side to the right. They hand off to Vaughn running right. He dives over the 25 down to about the 22-yard line. A gain of about 4 on the play. Blue Devils need to get it down to, looks like about the 17 for first down. Ball spotted just short of the 21-yard line of South.
Closer runs 3:10 to go. First
closer
down
to second down and 6. Hand off again, this time to Vaughn around the corner. I mean to Clark around the corner. Gets inside the 20 and may be off of close to a first down. They're going to spot him about a yard short, looks like.
Yeah, that's about what it looks like. Well, we're in 4-down territory now.
Bring up 3rd down and 1. Ball spotted at the 18. Devils need to make the 17 for a first down. Seth Clark back in the backfield at the H-back spot. A handoff this time to Clark, running left, and as he started to make his cut, his feet came out from under, but I believe he may have got to the 16. If he did, that's a first down.
Yeah, he's got the first down, and he might have had more. Might have had more, but his feet come out from under. Well, they didn't exactly give him the best spot ever was either.
No, well, they give him a first down, though, so they motioned that way.
Yeah.
You could tell from here he was, you know, at the 16, right at the 16.
All right.
It's first and 10 for the Blue Devils with 2:11 to go in the first half. Gate City trails south by a score of 14-7, ball on the south 16-yard line. Blue Devils this time hand off to Vaughn, and he's grabbed by the shirt and brought down after a pickup of a couple. And to be honest, that may have been a touchdown-saving tackle.
Yeah, it was a touchdown-saving tackle. That field must be just a little bit slick.
We're going to have to go in the dressing room at halftime, put some of those wristlands cleats in.
No comment.
It'll be second down and 7.
And it was only 20 years ago.
Yeah, I know, a long time ago. Ball at the south 18-yard line, 14-yard line, 13-yard line. I'll get you right before we quit. Devils in the shotgun. Bowen hands off straight up the middle to Clark. Gets close to the 10. Blue Devils need to get down to the 6-yard line for a first down. It's going to bring up third down and 5.
And we're going to have a timeout asked for on the field by Gate City. So we'll take a timeout too.
Back at Sullivan South. With 1:09 to go in the first half, Gate City with the ball on the south 11-yard line, third down and 5.
Have to get it to the 6.
Third down and 5 here. Clock won't start till the snap. Wing back set on the right, split backs in the backfield. And off this time is to Clark, and he gets brought down short of the 6. We'll see where they spot it, maybe the 8.
Well, they're just grabbing a handful of jersey, and we're going down just, I mean, it's, and we'll see. As Gate City looks like it's going to ask for another timeout, it looks to me like. It's going to be 4th and about 3. We'll be back.
Back at Solon South, 4th down and 2. Blue Devils have the ball on the south 8-yard line, need to get to the 6.
Well, this is not the end of it. This is a pretty critical play right here.
Oh, yeah.
We need to pick this first down up.
Devils this time go to an I formation, unbalanced line, strong side to the right, wing back to the right, head off to Clark, and it's going to be close.
That is going to be, depends on where he puts the ball down.
I think he got a favorable spot. He didn't move it forward, but it's going to be close.
It is going to be close. It's an inch either way.
Going to bring a change in now and see whether it's first and goal for Gate City or first and 10 for Sullivan South.
Dusty says he's got it, so we'll see. I like his thinking.
They stretch it. Put it down, and by the nose of the football, it's first and goal for the Blue Devils at the 6-yard line of Sullivan South with 45.6 tenths seconds to go in the first half. Blue Devils with only one timeout left here.
They have plenty of time.
Devils this time will put trips out to the left, one wide out to the right. Back in the backfield with Bowen is Pice is complete in the flat to Clark, who breaks it into the end zone, touchdown. Shook a tackle, took it in from 6 yards out, and the Devils score with 36 seconds to go.
They didn't knock us down that time, did they?
Nope.
Or drag us down that time. So the Blue Devils are an Logan Bird extra point away from having this thing tied up here with 36 seconds to go in the first half.
Franklin to hold. Russell's still the deep snapper, is he not, Mark?
Yes, he is.
Snap's good. Kick is up. Kick is good. So with 36 seconds to go in the first half, it's 14-14. Nick Bowen prepares to kick off here with 36 seconds to go. South with their touchdown maker from last week on kickoffs, Cody Medlin to the far side.
The thing you don't want to do here is give them something easy.
Kick it low and kind of squib kick it or something. As Bowen waits on the whistle to kick off. Nick approaches and hits a high end-over-end kick. It's going to be fielded at about the 6. Right up the middle is a seam, and the Blue Devils drag him down finally at the 30. On the return that time for South is Paul Wagner. So South will have it 1st and 10 at their own 31, with 29 seconds to go in the first half. Score tied 14-14.
And I think South has all their timeouts, probably.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I don't look for them just to set on.
No. No, with this kind of offense, I mean, you know, this is a, you run out of that spread, you're able to throw it at any time with all the wideouts you have. 3 to the right this time, 1 to the left. Devils in a 3 deep with their safeties as they've set up a screen that is blocked a little bit, but the man is finally brought out of bounds.
No, he ain't.
He ain't out of bounds. Nope, clock's still running. So, driven out of bounds at the 37. And now South will call timeout with 19.9 seconds to go in the half and take a timeout here.
Yeah, we'll take one.
Back at Sullivan South High School, 19.9 seconds to go here in the first half. Score is tied 14-14, Blue Devils and South Rebels. South with a second down and 3 on their own 38-yard line. Need to get it to the 41 for a first. 3 wide outs to the right, 1 to the left. Keith Hayden, the quarterback for Sullivan South, gets a snap, looks to his right, throws a little flare, pass out to the right, that's incomplete. Right in the hands of J.C. Garvin. Garvin is listed as a tight end, but also plays some wideout. He doesn't have the kind of size you'd normally see for a tight end.
No, is he a junior, I believe?
He is a junior, yeah. 6'3", 200.
Not as big as his brother was, I'm sure.
No.
Same height, but he still go 220 next year, though, probably.
3rd and 3 for South. As this time, Hayden keeps and is tackled from behind at the 45, has his first down. Clock stopped with 11.3 tenths seconds to go in the half.
We'll give them that.
Hayden on that little quarterback delay, and South takes his 3rd and final timeout.
And we'll take one too.
Back at Death Valley, home of the Sullivan South Rebels. South with the 1st and 10 on their own 45, 11.3 tenths seconds to go in the first half. And South out of timeout. Devils will drop to a 3 deep safety. Only rush 3 people and probably be dropping 8 back in coverage as Hayden looks, throws a pass over the middle, complete. That the man is going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. He'll have a 1st down. Clock will stop with 4 seconds to go in the half. And
South
evidently South had their 3rd timeout. I thought they'd already taken 3. My mistake.
We'll take one too.
Now South is out of timeout. 4 seconds to go. They have it 1st and 10 on the Blue Devil 33. So without a penalty on the defense here, this is probably going to be the last play of the first half.
Yep, just got to keep them
bottled up
outside the end zone and go to the half.
Hayden drops straight back, gets some pressure, now breaks over the middle, throws a long pass down the field. It's up for grabs and incomplete in the end zone. Good coverage down there by the Blue Devils' Tyler Bird.
And that'll be the end of the first half here at Sullivan South with a score. The Gate City Blue Devils 14, the Sullivan South Rebels 14.
back deep to receive the kickoff. On the near side for South is going to be Paul Wagner. On the far side is going to be Cody Medlin. As Bowen gets the signal and approaches the football at the 40, hits a high end-over-end kick. It hits at about the 16, fielded by Medlin at the 10, and he's brought down at about the 20 with a flag on the play. The flag is about 4 yards in advance of where the running back was brought down.
Plus all the way, three-quarters of the way across the field from where he was brought down. So if this is a penalty on South, that's just a killer. It's a chop block against South. That's just...
that's not even near the play.
No. Their coaches won't be happy with that young man. I mean, that was on the near hash mark, and the runner was tackled on the number on the far side of the field.
So the penalty will be marked off back to the 10-yard line. South with it, football on its own 10. It'll be first and 10 from the 10. As the Blue Devils have them backed up deep here.
Yeah, I need to keep them back here. They've not had the best night punting for distance, so get them three and out here.
Hayden with one back in the backfield. Devils in a eight-man line and show blitz. Now they come hard after Hayden, and there's a guy that's grabbed in the backfield. Long pass down the field. That's complete. It's a 40. Blue Devils bring him down. It's a 41, but Blue Devils had a defensive man going after the quarterback. That guy just reached out and grabbed his jersey.
Well, still yet, though. Had him backed up. Had pretty good pressure on him and just let him roll out.
Yeah,
the man was wide open because we... You know, we had about five or six coming after him and had way too much time to throw.
We got to close the ends off a little bit. Ball at the 41-yard line. Make him cut back and run inside. Hayden throws a little flare out pass. It's too high and incomplete for his running back, Castle. As Castle sprinted out of the backfield.
Seth Clark had a bead on Castle, too. If he'd have got that ball, it's going to be a big collision.
So it'll be second down and 10 now for the Rebels at their own 42. 11:28 to go in the third quarter. Score tied 14-14. South, as it has all night, with two wide outs, this time to the right, one to the left, and a tight end in on the right side. Castle in the backfield with Hayden. Devils again with showing blitz from a corner. Hayden. Yeah, this has got to be a screen. Pass complete, but the Blue Devils played it well and throw him 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage at the 39.
Yeah, they saw it. I saw it. Everybody saw it.
Seth Clark, one of the guys in on the tackle short.
Yeah, that time we recognized it. First time they did it, they gashed us good with it, but that time we had that one cut.
Seaver Elliott also in on the tackle for Gate City. So that brings up third down now on 13.
One thing about it, if you're getting to the quarterback really, really easily, you need to stop because it's probably going to be a screen.
It's going to be a screen.
Peel back.
Again, two wide outs to the right. Blue Devils in a two-deep safety. We only have one linebacker here. As Hayden keeps it, cuts these right, breaks the tackle, and has a first down at the Blue Devil 45. He's a pretty good open field runner.
Well,
Seth Clark is the only guy that had a shot at him.
When you don't get hit to your 15 yards downfield, anybody can run.
Yeah.
I mean, their best bet snapped to him to let him run.
Yeah. So Hayden with a first down at the Blue Devil 44-yard line. South coming off their own 10-yard line after the kickoff. Hayden this time hands off to his running back off of right guard and gets about 4 to the 40. That was Castle on the carry. He hadn't carried the ball that many times tonight. Actually give him about 5. It's going to be second down and 5 for South at the 39-yard line. Gate City's 39. Two wide outs to the right, one to the left. Castle in the backfield along with Hayden. High snap, handoff to Castle running left, and he's hit behind the line of scrimmage. It almost spun out of the tackle, but the Blue Devils able to bring him down with Seth Clark behind the line. Let's see where they spotted at the 41.
Guess they had to let Hagen catch 39. His breath. Something I figure.
They spot it back, just short of the 40-yard line. It's going to be third down and about seven with 9:15 to go, third quarter. Score tied 14-14. Blue Devils, extra men on the corners. Going fumble ball that goes right into the hands of a Blue Devil and recovered at the 44-yard line. Bledsoe on their fumble recovery.
He went to hand it off to Castle, and I don't know if Castle knocked it out of his hand or it slipped out of Hayden's hand or what, but...
Bounced right to Michael Bledsoe.
Yeah, I mean, without a doubt, that'll be the easiest fumble recovery he'll ever make.
So the Blue Devils have it now at their own 43, first and 10, with 9:01 to go, third quarter, score tied 14-14. Devils put a wing back in motion, pitch it to Franklin, running left. He breaks one tackle, gets across the 45, drags tacklers with him across midfield. Smallest man on the team almost, struggled for 8 yards.
Yep. He got all 130 pounds going in the right direction, didn't he?
Corey Franklin, 5'7", 148, and that's wet.
Yeah.
I mean, that's soaking wet.
Yeah, I don't know if he'll weigh that with gear on. And Corey, he asked to come out a little bit. Don't blame him.
It's going to be second down and one after the 9-yard gain by Franklin. But he kept his legs moving, Mark.
Yeah. One of which got injured just a little bit. He's okay.
Double wing back set for the Blue Devils as Tyler Bird goes in motion. They hand off to Vaughn. He has his first down. I think it's Vaughn. Let me double check.
Yep.
It was. Across the south 45 down to the 44. I was looking for our Dusty Clark on the sideline. May just be getting a break after playing defense. Devils with shotgun. Bowen rolls to his right, looks, throws a long pass down the field, has a man wide open. Montana Morris at the 15. Tackled inside the 10 at the 9.
Great throw.
Laid it up, Montana ran under it, made a good catch.
Yeah, great throwing catch. That's two sophomores doing that too.
It'll be first and goal at the 10. Looks like they're going to spot it. Nose of the football just on the 10.
Yeah, it's
a little less than 10 yards, but it's first and goal. Devils this time with split backs, wing back set to the left. They hand out to Clark, who's back into the ball game. Gets inside the 10, only gains maybe a yard that time, down to the 9. Dusty really was looking for a hole that time, and it didn't open up. So bring up second down and goal from the 9-yard line for Gate City. 7:15 to go, third quarter. Score tied 14-14. End of the ball game for the Blue Devils at wideout. Michael Collier split out wide to the left. Franklin split out wide to the right. Split backs in the backfield as Clark goes in motion left. Hand off, pitch back to Vaughn, and he's thrown behind the line of scrimmage for a loss, back to about the 13.
Every time we've done that, they've done that. They've got something on us right there.
We're not getting that, whoever's playing that outside linebacker spot or the end. It looks like our flanker might be the guy that's supposed to hit him, but he's running wide of him every time. So it's third down and goal now from about the 12-yard line. Third and goal from the south 12, full house backfield. Two tight ends, fumble, snap. Hand off to Clark, running right, and he might have lost another yard. Might have got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's going to be fourth down and goal from about the 12-yard line, and into the ball game is going to come Logan Bird to try his second field goal attempt of the night. This one will be spotted at the 20 we should make it a 30-yard field goal. Even I can do that, man.
Yeah, 20 and 10 is pretty easy.
Yeah. That last one you missed was 31. This one just a yard closer.
More in the center of the field, though.
Yeah, a little bit more in the center of the field. High snap, but he kicks it high, and he kicks it good. Blue Devils on top, 17-14.
We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Back deep again for South after the field goal by Logan Bird. Near side, same two it's been all night. Paul Wagner on the near side. On the far side is Cody Medlin. Nick Bowen to kick off for the Blue Devils. Devils, for the first time tonight, have a lead at 17-14. As Bowen approaches the football, it's a high end-over-end kick. It's going to be fielded by Wagner at the 5, up to the 10, 15, and finally brought down at about the 25. South does a pretty good job of blocking these kickoffs.
Yeah,
he just about had a crease to get through there.
So the Blue Devils take the South turnover, converted into 3 points. Now it's up to the defense to stop them, and that's a hard thing
to
do.
Or get another turnover.
Well, that would stop them. But
first and 10 for South at their own 25. Two wideouts to each side this time. As Hayden puts his wing back in motion. They fake a give to him, and Hayden has hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's a good little runner, I tell you.
Yes, he is.
He breaks it forward for about a 2-yard gain. Well, he's not really little. He's 6'1", 175.
Yeah. No, he's a good runner. And he throws it pretty good, too.
Yeah, he does. And was a wideout before.
Good high school quarterback, no question.
The second down and 8 for South. Again, two wideouts to each side. Slot goes in motion from left to right. Now you got three wideouts on the right side. They hand it off inside to Castle, and the Blue Devils stop him short of the 30 at about the 29. A little motion to the right. Castle tried to run back to the left, and Gate City waiting on it with Seth Clark and maybe Miller on the tackle that time for the Blue Devils. Going to bring up 3rd down and 6 for South.
A big stop right here.
4:15 to go, third quarter. Devils on top, 17-14 over the Sullivan South Rebels. Looks like they're having a little problem trying to get everybody lined up. Two wideouts to each side again.
Play clock's got to be running down if they had one.
That wing back on the left goes in motion again, same set. Three wideouts to the right. Devils get pressure. Blitzall throws a ball that, gets to the quarterback and might have caused Hayden to throw it just a little quick, a little long out of the reach of his intended receiver, Drew Shanks.
You know, they don't block our two outside rushers, do they?
No, they just let them go.
They let them go, and they block the middle, and they leave it up to Hayden to know those two outside rushers are coming to get rid of it.
Or to use his good footwork and running the ability to get away from
him. Yeah, and we've run by him a time or two doing that.
There's the punt. Devils go for the block. Don't get it as Vaughn went back. Looked like he's going to field the football and just let it go over his head, and he got about a 15-yard roll down to the Blue Devil 20. So Gate City, instead of having it on the 30, if he makes the fair catch, is going to have it on their own 20.
3:37 to go here in the third quarter, 17-14, Gate City with the lead.
Devils need one of those old-timey Blue Devil 7.5, 8-minute drives, points on the other end.
Or one play 80 yards is worth.
Yeah, that little quick pass we threw last week.
Yeah, I think our competition's
ready for that.
A little better this week.
Oh, yeah, much better. Devils with double wing backs to each side. Put the wing back on the left-hand side in motion. Hand off to Bond. And that handoff didn't look the smoothest in the world, but Bond able to pick up 3 yards. Bring up, give him 2 yards. Bring up 2nd down. I still think it's 3. 2nd down and 7. Yeah, ball got spotted down to 23, so it had to be three.
Yeah. Need some first downs anyway. And what do we got?
I think we're going to have an official's timeout for some reason. Oh, South has a player that had to do a little repair on his uniform.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know they'd give you a timeout, just pull your socks up. Devils in the shotgun. Two backs, one on each side of Bowen. And Bowen throws the pass over the middle. Oh! Intercepted. Yep. That ball is intercepted.
Yep.
That ball is intercepted on a good interception by A.J. Hutchins, number 25.
Yep, tipped it to himself. Pass was high.
And the receiver was pretty well covered, too.
Yep.
So, another pass interception by Gatesy. Now, South has the ball at the Blue Devils 43-yard line, first and 10, with 2:52 to go.
It'll be put back to Hayden Sands now.
Oh, yeah. They again go trips to the right. Hayden looks to his right. Now throws a little screen pass back to the left. Seth Clark grabs hold.
Oh,
Devils not able to bring him down, and he's gonna go down to the 5-yard line.
Yep.
That was Castle on the carry. Blue Devils had him tackled after about a 5-yard gain, and he breaks loose and gets all the way down to the Blue Devil 5. And Castle a little slow getting up after that. As Castle may have a crank the way he's walking in his
yeah,
his leg.
So it looks like he's probably does have, and while they tend to Castle, we'll take a break. Back at 60 South.
Back at Sullivan South High School as Jordan Castle able to limp off the field under his own power. He's looks like he just had a cramp in that calf muscle on his left leg. But the key to the whole thing is your South has it first and goal on the Blue Devil 5. With a very elusive quarterback for Sullivan South and Keith Hayden. And South with an excellent chance to go on back on top here in this game.
Well, we just got to find a way to keep them out of the end zone.
New man in the backfield for South is Weaver. Hayden, I think, goes under center maybe for only the second time tonight. As he throws that pass into the end zone, touchdown. 5-yard pass complete to J.C. Garvin, the tight end.
Took advantage of their size, threw it up. Garvin ran under it for the 6. So it puts the Rebels on top, 20-17, with 2:14 to go here in the third quarter. And they'll have on to attempt the extra point, Taylor Moore.
Snap a little high, kick is up, and the kick's good. So South goes on top of the Blue Devils by a score of 21-17.
We'll be back.
Back at Sullivan South High School, where the Rebels, if you just turned on the radio, just went ahead of the Blue Devils on a 5-yard touchdown pass from Heath Hayden to J.C. Garvin. After the Blue Devils apparently had the running back stopped after a 3 or 4 yard gain, broke those tackles and ran it all the way down to the 5. First play, Hayden throws a 5-yard touchdown pass to Garvin. Now South will kick off. Far side, Montana Morris. Near side, Joseph Vaughn. For the Blue Devils. Two 2:14 left, third quarter. South on top. 21-17. High end over end kick is going to be fielded by Morris at the 6. Up across the 15, 20, dropped down at the 25-yard line. Montana's one of those kids, if he can get in the open, he's going to do it.
Yep. Yep. I liked how he ran that kick off back. Got it. went up the field.
Didn't stutter around, ran hard. First and 10 for Gate City at their own 25. Blue Devils with back in the shotgun, Bowen. Vaughn to his left, Dusty Clark to his right. Wide out to each side, they hand off to Dusty Clark trying to run left. And breaks a tackle, gets around the corner and stumbled, knocked out of bounds. Well, knocked out of bounds because the clock keeps running up across the 30 to about the 33-yard line, about 2 yards short of a first down. Clark just a couple steps and a little balance away from turning that thing all the way up to two.
He's got pretty good balance.
Be second down and three for Gate City. Need to get to the 35.
Oh.
And the Blue Devils have a procedure penalty.
Mistakes.
Weren't on the same snap count. So that 5 yard penalty makes it, instead of being second down and three, is going to be second down and eight now. Micah Bledsoe into the lineup for the Blue Devils to replace Seaver Elliott. Bledsoe at a wing back on the left side. That looked almost like his motion. And off to Vaughn, cuts it inside, breaks it into the open, 45-50, 45-40, 35-30. No flags, and Joseph Vaughn will take it all the way into the end zone for a touchdown. That is 73-yard touchdown. And the Devils come right back with 59 seconds to go.
So Logan Bird on to attempt the extra point. Trying to give Gate City their 3-point lead back. And he does.
Devils go back on top by a score of 24-21.
Back in 60.
Nick Bowen prepares to kick off after Joseph Vaughn ran 73 yards for a touchdown. Vaughn on two carries has over 120 yards just in two carries tonight. As Bowen hits the football high, end over end kick, it's short and fumble back inside the 15. Devils have the pressure on, now they can throw him out of bounds. They do throw him out of bounds this time at about the 17 yard line. Wagner that time. Well, Devils have missed a few tackles tonight.
Well, they have, but I'll tell you what, man, South missed some too.
Pretty evenly played football.
Pretty even, two pretty even teams. One of them's going to win, one of them's going to lose here tonight, but they're pretty equal.
51.510 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Devils on top by a score of 24-21. Hayden with one back in the backfield. Trips on the left-hand side. Hayden
reverse.
Runs a reverse.
Oh, boy.
And it's got yardage. I mean, it's got yardage to boot. As the man is finally brought down across the 40 at about the 45, and on that carry was 42 for South. That would be Jimmy Steffi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we...
Yeah, they had that...
That's easy to see up here that's
oh, yeah.
Down there. It's not.
They had all the blocking. Looked like he's going to run left and then hand it off to the left and then hand it back on the reverse and right. The whole right side of the field was wide open.
Gate City's going to ask for a timeout. Timeout on the field. We'll be back in 60.
First and 10 for the Rebels at their own 45-yard line with 36.6 tenths seconds to go here in the third quarter. That reverse gave South good field position as Hayden on the keeper this time. Runs left, cuts it inside, and gains maybe three on the play. Maybe only two up to the 47. Just the old Southern Cal sweep to the left.
You say so. I gotta believe it.
Trips this time to the right. Pretty much the same formation except the opposite side. They hand off to the back out of the backfield, and he breaks the tackle and gets across the Blue Devil 40 down to the 36 yard.
And that's a good call. Our middle linebacker, Clark, got held. Seth got held, no question about it. Not the first time tonight.
It was Weaver on the carry, but the flag, the yellow hanky.
Yeah, that's a good call there. I mean, he really did hold it.
That'll be marked off from Gate City's 40, about their 48-yard line.
Be second and, what, 12, roughly?
Yeah, 12 or 13 somewhere.
And I guess that'll be the end of the quarter, but we'll hold it right here. There's no decision to make here.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I would think they'd step it off,
and it should
mark
be.
It, and then say this is the end of the third quarter. Moves it all the way back to the 43-yard line of south.
And it will be second and 12.
I think he's going to say there's going to be one untimed down.
Yeah, I guess it's I've seen that before. I really thought that.
I thought a penalty on the offense. And
that might just be at the half and not a quarter. I don't know. But anyway, maybe. There'll be an untimed down.
Second down and 12. With zeros on the clock. Blue Devils with all 11 pretty close to the line of scrimmage defensively. I mean,
that's a risk.
Over here, you've got
reverse.
They hand off, fake a reverse. Hayden throws a long pass down the middle, that the man is wide open. Makes the catch at the 20, goes all the way in the end zone for a touchdown.
Yep.
That is a 57-yard touchdown.
Yeah, we had, like you said, 11 men within 3 or 4 yards of the line of scrimmage, and it was just a matter of getting somebody down there. And that was too easy. So it makes it 27-24 south. They will attempt the extra point. More again to attempt. And here's the kick.
Kick's good. South goes on top of Gate City by a score of 28-24.
So after three quarters of play, South 28, Gate City 24.
Back at Sullivan South, where we're about ready to start the fourth quarter. South, with no time on the clock at the end of the third quarter, hit a 57-yard touchdown pass from Hayden to Drew Shanks.
Yeah, I don't know exactly. Obviously, we had a major, major bust in coverage there. Their receiver, there was nobody within literally 30 yards of him.
No.
All Hayden had to do was just get the ball off, and it was going to be a touchdown as long as he caught it. That's major bust. That wasn't just a little one. So the Blue Devils will get it back. Looks like we're going to have to outscore them.
Looks that way.
Well, of course, you have to outscore them. Even if it's 3-0, you have to outscore them. But you know what I mean.
I know what you mean. Kind of looks like a last one has a football. They have a chance to win the ball game.
Yeah, because defensively, neither one of them stopped the other one very much.
Blue Devils We'll have Vaughn back deep, along with Montana Morris. And the kick is going to be fielded by Morris at the 9, up to the 15, the 20. Now we got a hanky that's come out here, and Gate City is probably going to be called for a hold on the kickoff.
Yeah.
Flag is at the Blue Devil 20, about the 28-yard line.
So
that means Gate City is going to be backed up and start pretty deep in their own territory.
Got the 18. Thing. Yep.
Holding called on the Blue Devils. we have pretty much been, we haven't had all that many penalties tonight, have we? A legal procedure. One or two.
Yeah.
I believe that's the first holding call tonight on Gatesy. That'll put the ball back to the 19-yard line, looks like. It'll be first and 10 for the Blue Devils from our own 19. Devils with wing back and two setbacks, and this time Bowen will be under center. Seth Clark is the wing back. Bowen on the keeper run, sees left, gets across the 25 to maybe the 26-yard line. Gain of right at six on the play. Going to bring up about a 7-yard gain. It's going to bring up second down and seven. Second down and three. Devils need to get it to about the clock at 29. And off to Vaughn, running right, breaks the tackle. He breaks it into the open. 40. South has the angle on him. And will drag him out of bounds inside the South 30-yard line at the 27. The only thing that saved that from being another long touchdown by Joseph Vaughn was three players from South, defensive players, had an angle on him.
Yep.
So the Blue Devils will again threaten. Be down to the spotted on the 20, looks like a 28-yard line. This time, and what looks to be a wingback. Boy, I thought we moved. Hand off that time to Clark out of the backfield. And he gets down to the 25-yard line. Gain of two on the play brings up second down and eight. Devils need to get it down to the 18 of Sullivan South for a first down. Again. Wishbone. And Bowen on the keeper. Big hole. Cuts it inside. Gets to the 10. 5. Spins for the end zone. Dropped down at the 2. Ball fumble.
No, it's down.
But he has to be down.
Although
the officials don't act like it's down.
Well, he was down. And if he ain't, it's a touchdown.
It's a touchdown.
It is a touchdown.
Oh, he recovered the fumble. No, he wasn't down.
Yeah, he was. Too.
I thought he was, too. Who recovered the fumble?
I have
73, done. Maybe, for the Blue Devils?
He was down. I'm sorry.
When he hit the ground, the reason the ball came out.
Yeah.
He hit the ground, the ball. That could be, if that was 73, it'd be Cody Vaughn.
Yeah. All I know is he had the ball. He hit the ground. The ball bounces into the end zone, and we fall on it, and they give us a touchdown.
I'm going to give it to him.
Logan Bird on the attempt, the extra point. And it's plenty good, 31-28, 10 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. We'll be back.
Bowen's kick, a high end-over-end kick. It's going to be fielded by Medlin at the 10. Looks for the wedge and almost gets through, but the Blue Devils bring him down at the 30.
Just like you said earlier, just about every time, whoever returns it for them is just about close to breaking.
It looks like Gate City only has one man to bring him down. That's about it. Even though you had a bunch of people all stacked up in there because of.
Yeah, they do a pretty good job on their kick, but now we covered it pretty well, too.
Yeah.
I mean, 30 or in, that's pretty good.
Well, we've stayed in our lanes pretty good getting down the field.
Well, let's see if we can stop it. First one that gets a stop wins.
Hayden in the backfield. Let's see if Castle's back there with him again. Now, this time they have trips to the right. Hayden starts to the right, gets hit at the line of scrimmage on a big leg from, might have been Blitzoff.
I believe it was.
It was. Yeah, because it drove Bledsoe's helmet on his down on his head a little bit. But yeah. That's a good tackle by Micah Bledsoe.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. When he hit him, Hayden went backwards. He's not going backwards much tonight, but he did on that one.
Again, those trips to the left, one wide out to the right. Hand off to the running back out of the backfield, and the Blue Devils bring him down after a gain of close to 5 yards, 4 yards on the carry. Weaver on the carry that time for South. It's going to bring up third down at about six. They need to get it, looks like, to the 40. It'll be third down and five. That's kind of what I thought.
Well, they need a stop here. Need a stop.
Weaver still in the backfield with Hayden. Same formation. And they fake it. Nope. Hayden keeps it, and here he goes.
Yep.
Spins out of a tackle. Finally brought down Bavon in Blue Devil territory at the 45. And Dusty Clark comes off limping.
I think he's got a cramp. I hope that's what it is. And I believe it is. It is.
Yeah, it acts like it is.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, you got two pretty good high school players here, one a Joseph Vaughn and one a
Hayden.
And Hayden. First and 10 for South at the Blue Devil 45. Hayden, straight handoff to his back out of the backfield. And stopped maybe after a yard gain on the play. That is Weaver again. Gets 2 yards, bringing second down and eight for South at the Blue Devil 42-yard line. Same formation with all those wideouts stacked up on the left side. Hayden rolls to his left this time. That was a hole.
Yeah.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah. Garson. I mean, I don't get it.
I don't either.
Watch it on film. I mean,
his arm is plumb over his shoulder.
Yeah. Garvin was behind him, and like you said, had his arm over his shoulder, or defender's shoulder pad, and pulled him to him.
But even at that, no gain. So third down and five. I don't see how any official could miss something like that. I mean, you're not born with three arms.
No.
Third and five. They have the power to the left-hand side. Hayden rolls to his left. Got it. And it's dropped down. Sacked from behind.
Bo Moore, 32, was the first man in there. And
that's
who's 30, the
34 for the Blue Devils also.
Civarelli.
Civarelli.
Yeah.
And 32 is Bo Moore's.
Yep. They both got there and got enough of Hayden to knock him down. He should be getting a little wobbly.
Blue Devil's not 100% sure here they're going to punt. The Devils had 12 on to get one off. Vaughn will drop back deep. Punt is a high wobbly punt. It comes to the near sideline, takes a Blue Devil bounce, and goes out of bounds at the Blue Devil 25. Vaughn was standing at the 15, so the Blue Devils get a pretty good bounce. Well, not a real good punt from Sullivan South.
Now, let's get a 6 minute and 45 second drive.
I'm for it. First and 10 for Gate City at around 25, 6:47 to go. Fourth quarter, Gate City leads by a score 31-28.
We're gonna be short a player because Clark is out with a cramp.
Well, we're gonna get Montana Morris into the ball game. Yeah, let's make sure we get the play call here and run in the correct amount of seconds. Full house for the Blue Devils. Two tight ends. Put the right halfback in motion. Morris, hand off to Vaughn out of the backfield.
Oh,
and he's tripped up after a gain of 10. One step from going all the way again.
Well, he was one step of going until he ran out of gas.
Yeah.
I don't know that he could have sprinted 70 yards or not.
Well, that's probably true.
But I'll tell you one thing. I'd like to see the end of it.
First and 10 for the Blue Devils at their own 36 with 6:35 to go in the ball game. Gate City on top by a score of 31-28. Devils with two back set, a wing back on the left-hand side, power side to the right. Bowen on the keeper, maybe gains a yard. South played that pretty well this time. We ran away from the strong side, ran back to the weak side, and Bowen able to pick up. Yeah, might not have picked up anything. Gonna be second down and call it nine.
Watching them work with Dusty Clark down here on the sideline. Dusty, I don't believe he's gonna be able to come back. He's really cramped up badly, especially in his left leg. I'll be surprised. Pouring liquids in him, but
a little late to do that now. Yeah. You got to drink them liquids the day before. Hand off, straight up the middle. Off tackle. Gain of a couple, three on the play. And on the carry that time was, you would think, Vaughn. And it is. That's going to be third down and maybe one of the biggest plays of the game for Gate City. Need a first down here. It's going to be third and seven. First down keeps the clock running here.
Just about can't afford to throw it, though.
Devils with a wing back on the right. Split backs in the backfield, wide out to the right. Bowen hands off to Vaughn, running right, and he gets maybe a yard. So, Blue Devils play pretty safe here. Back deep for South is going to be Wagner. He'll stand inside his 30 as we have a injured Blue Devil on the field.
Maybe Vaughn, I'm not sure. We'll take a break and be right back.
Seaver Elliott, the injured Blue Devil, it looked like he just cranked up a little bit too. So the Devils with fourth down and five will have to kick off, or punt rather.
This is
back deep is Wagner for South.
This is where South has the advantage. They don't have to play as many people both ways. It's where there's practically nobody. And that right here is where it begins to show the depth that they have versus us.
Low snap. And Miller gets off a bad punt off the side of his foot, but it takes a pretty good Blue Devil roll. And Devils will down it inside the 25-yard line at about the 23.
Now the question is, Larry, who do we have that can answer the bell here to play?
Well, that's true.
Elliott is not going to be able to play.
Here comes Seth Clark off the field also limping with cramp.
So your two linebackers are out.
Yep.
The two starters.
End of the ball game for Gate City is going to be 32. That's Bo Morris.
Dusty Clark says he's about ready to go, but now I don't know. He's,
you know, those things you think you're better till you have to take off and run a step or two.
Well, we've got some young people that's got to grow up here.
Well, it looks like Micah Bledsoe is in. And Devils with a two-deep safety cover. As Hayden, they have Tripp on the right, wide out to the left. Hayden on the keeper, breaks a tackle, cuts it inside, and finally brought down up across his own 35 to his 36. 11-yard gain, first down by Hayden.
Well,
as Dusty Clark does come back into the ball game for Gate City.
Yeah, but he's really favoring that leg. Got that cramp in it.
It's going to be the Hayden show, my guess is, from here on out. Pretty much has been anyhow.
Well, that and the fact that he only plays one way, and that's not an excuse.
That's
a fact. And he's a lot fresher than our guys. You know, we just need to get one more stop on him. Somehow.
First and 10 for ourselves with 3:55 to go. Hayden on the keeper again. This time he's stacked up after a gain maybe of two. The Devil's right side over there with Bledsoe and looks like
Russell
Aaron Kaiser, number 40.
40.
In on the tackle that time. Gain of two brings up second down and eight. 3:30 to go in the ball game. Gate City on top by a score of 31-28.
And Seaver Elliott, he doesn't have a cramp, Larry. They're taping an ankle.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
I just noticed the way he limped
off. Yeah, that's what I thought too. And he may have had a cramp, but they are retaping an ankle.
The Devils in this formation only have one safety back, and that's Dusty Clark. As Hayden drops straight back, looks, gets a little bit of pressure, now rolls to his right, has that open field again.
Oh, he's across the line of scrimmage.
And across the line of scrimmage.
And they got him.
They got him. Yep, they got him. Pass was complete, but he was definitely through the ball from the 41, the line of scrimmage was the 39.
Yeah, and they caught the ball, though.
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah. Pass was complete.
Yeah, but... Now that is a loss of down, is that not
it's
right?
It's supposed to be.
Penalty plus loss of down, I do believe.
Yeah, that should make it what is that, a 10-yard penalty?
I believe it is.
10-yard penalty and loss of down. Should make it third down.
17.
Yep. Got to bring him over here where the, bring him over here where the coaches could
help.
Tell him exactly what they want. All he had to do was stop just a yard short and turn that thing loose. And he had a big play. But they've been here before.
That's a 5-yard penalty.
It's a 5-yard penalty, but it should be a loss of down there. So that makes it third down. About 11, 12 yards to go with 3 minutes and 1 second to go in the ball game. Gate City on top of the score, 31-28. They have a wide out to the left side. Double wide outs to the right side.
All right, white team, let's give us a stop.
And Hayden in the backfield. Wing back goes in motion from right to left. Hayden rolls to his left, looks back now, has that pass over the middle that we had it diagnosed, and he's still running, and he may go all the way. But we bring him down at the 35-yard line. We had people up there to tackle him, it just didn't ramp up. So, South now with the ball down to the Blue Devil 35. I thought once he broke out in the open, who stopped him, Dusty Clark?
They ran three screens tonight. Two of them worked, one of them didn't.
Yep.
Yep, 2:43 to go, clock runs.
Man, you wouldn't expect anything out of this South team any less. Hayden is one of the better quarterbacks that we've seen and will see all year.
No question.
Hayden, this time hands off to his running back who has some running room and breaks tackles inside the Blue Devil 25 down to about the 23-yard line. On the tackle that time for Gate City was Vaughn, Joseph Vaughn.
Logan Russell able to get back in there, and here comes Seth Clark trying to get back in.
So South has it first and 10 now at the Blue Devil 23-yard line. Two wide outs to the left, one to the right. Put the wing back on the left side in motion. And hand it off to Hubbard, who breaks tackles inside the bubble of football. Gate City has recovered. I can see it from here. Blue Devils have recovered it inside the 5 at the 4-yard line. So a good tackle by a Blue Devil that we can't say who it was, but they stripped him of the football. And Montana Moore,
Corey Franklin.
Corey Franklin, the man, came up with it.
It might have been Morris that stripped it.
May have been.
I'm not sure. Still. So now we've got to get some first down South with all three of their timeouts. 2 minutes, 3 seconds to go. And, of course, can't turn the football over.
That's true. All right, Vaughn, and see who we're going to have in the backfield. We got enough people in there yet?
I don't know if we got enough bodies eligible.
I don't think we do. We got to have somebody. And you can't take a penalty here. You got to let the clock run down.
I think they're going to take a timeout.
Yeah, but the thing about this, your clock not running.
Timeout on the field. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Full house backfield, handoff is to Clark running right, and he gets up across the 5 to about the 7. And South will call a timeout here, I'd say.
Yep. Looks like South takes the timeout. I'll tell you what, let's just hold it here this time, and because if they stop us on the next down, they'll call another timeout. I guess they call one.
Well, if you're able to get one first down, the ball game's over. If you hold on, you can take knees after that.
Yeah, if you can get one first down, they are down to two timeouts.
Take one after the second down play.
What did we get? We got pretty good yardage on that.
Yeah, we got across the 5 out to about the 7, looks like. It's going to be second down about 6, looks like. Devils need to get it to their own 13-yard line.
Well, like you say, I mean, it's...
minute 57 to go in the game. Blue Devils deep in their own territory, full house. Sophomore quarterback Nick Bowen under center. Snap, handoff, round the end. Clark gets across at the end of the 13. Should be first and 10, Blue Devils.
I don't know, Larry.
It's going to be close.
Yep, it's going to be real close. I don't know if he got it or not.
Oh, yeah. Just need to get to 13. They're spotting it in between the 13 and the 14.
No, he's got to get close to the 4-yard line.
14-yard
line.
Yeah,
I believe he's short. He is short.
It's going to be third down and inches.
And South has asked for the timeout. That is their
second.
So a first down here, and barring disaster.
Well, first down here. If you get a first down here on third down, even with South with one timeout left, you can still take three knees and the ball game basically be over.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Because be
25 50, seconds.
75 seconds, and you've got, what, 106 left.
Yeah.
Plus what it takes to run the play. So, like I say, I mean, we have got to get this first down right here. And if we can do that, and then hold on to the football.
Elliott with his headgear back on. Looks like he's ready to go. Thought they might actually put him in there with the Blue Devils with a full house.
South's got a sellout, don't
they? Yeah, they got to.
Quarterback sneaks.
And we put the right half back in motion, and the quarterback keeper gets a first down up to the 15-yard line. Bowen has picked up a big first down for the Blue Devils. Clock will stop with a minute 42 to go in the game.
And Lebanon come back to beat Tazewell 31-24.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what. Instead of John Adams running his power out, he gets behind now, and he evidently has got a quarterback to throw the football.
Well, I don't know. Now, let's see, South did not call their timeout.
No. So minute 20 to go.
I would
full house again.
Would not risk a hand.
Again. Put it back in motion. And they almost stripped Vaughn, but they're going after the football. He might have lost a half yard.
And
South will call a timeout.
So we'll just keep it right here. With a minute 7 to go, we take a snap. 50 seconds. This game's over. They can't stop a block again. If we don't turn it over, they can't possibly get it back.
No.
Because 2:25 second clocks on second and third down, and then you're standing there on fourth down and
just letting it run
out.
Yeah.
You've got 75 seconds, and there's only 67 left. So this game's over if we don't turn it over. I mean, that's just – I'm not real good at that math stuff, but
you are.
I'm good enough to know that –
that's the reason you got all that money you got. You're good.
You ain't talking to my banker, have you?
It'll be a second down and 10 for the Blue Devils from their own 15-yard line with 1:07 to go in the game. And Mark has calculated all this out in his head.
No, it's just fall on the football. There's no need to do anything but that.
No. Bowen takes a knee.
Hey, the clock hasn't started. The clock's not started.
Oh.
Yeah.
Boy.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah. Now it's running.
Yeah, but.
Well, that's okay. What the referee needs to do is just not mark it in play.
Right.
And he's not. He's being deliberate. Now, all we have to do is take one more knee.
We'll be close.
I wouldn't snap it until the back judge raises it. He gives you a 5 count.
Yeah.
And Bowen is looking right at him.
Just don't look at him.
Now
miss the football.
He can snap it now, and it's over. It's over. 20 seconds to go. We don't.
Bowen takes a knee, and the Blue Devils have come across the state line to Sullivan South and come away with a 1-28 victory.
A hard-earned, well-deserved victory. Let me tell you something. Folks, our kids gutted this one out. We, about 7 minutes to go in this football game, we were hurting physically. With lots of, you know, kids cramping up and yeah, we gutted this one out. Our kids on the field gutted this one out.
Now that's the only bad thing about, you know, not having that many people where you have to play both ways, but it's worked for Gate City for a number of years.
Yeah. And but it's a you know, this is a big victory against a good football team, and the thing, like the thing I'm going back to again is this was a tough victory because, you know, we had to have some people step up a little bit when we had starters go down, and this could be the start of a really, really good football season. We've done well here tonight. We really did.
Well, I'll tell you something else. Somebody I want to really brag on is Nick Bowen. He threw two interceptions tonight. Mm-hmm. But he overcame that.
Sure.
I mean, he's almost like a freshman starting. I mean, he's a sophomore starting his third game of the
third game of the season. Career.
And he did a good job. But those seniors around him,
exactly.
Joseph Vaughn, Dusty Clark, all those guys have helped him, you know.
Exactly. And Clark, you know, being back and able to play the most minutes he's been able to play this year tonight made a difference. Made a big difference. And but the Blue Devils certainly this is a victory that people's going to pay attention to.
Yeah.
This is a big win against a good football team at their house, and that's not much more than you can say about that. You want to look at the final scoring.
Yeah, the final scoring went this way: Sullivan South scored a 13-yard touchdown. With Hayden going in with 4:44 to go in the first quarter. South went on top by a score 7-0 after Moore's PAT was good. Gate City came back. Well, Gate City didn't come back right then. Gate City recovered a South fumble on a punt at the Sullivan South 19-yard line and missed a 31-yard field goal. That was all the scoring in the first quarter. In the second quarter, Joseph Vaughn had a 51-yard touchdown run. With 9:33 to go in the second quarter, Bird's point after was good. Score tied 7-7. South came right back with Heath Hayden on a 49-yard touchdown run with 8:10 to go in the second quarter. Taylor Moore's point after good, and South back on top 14-7. And then Nick Bowen to Dusty Clark on a 6-yard touchdown pass with 36 seconds left in the second quarter. Bird's point after good, and the score at the half was 14-14. Gate City got on the board first in the second half. Logan Bird on a 30-yard field goal with 5:29 to go in the third quarter put Gate City on top 17-14. Hayden came right back with a 5-yard touchdown pass to J.C. Garvin with 2:11 to go in the third quarter, and the point after by Moore was good, and South went on top by a score 21-17. Still in the third quarter with 59 seconds to go, Joseph Vaughn had a 73-yard touchdown run. The point after by Bird was good. Gate City back on top 24-21. And also in the third quarter with no time left, Hayden on a 57-yard touchdown strike to Drew Shanks. Moore's point after was good, and South led after three quarters, 28-24. And then in the fourth quarter, the only scoring in the fourth quarter, Cody Vaughn recovered a Nick Bowen fumble in the end zone for the Blue Devils. Point after by Bird was good. Gate City on top 31-28. And that's the final score. South had a chance. Fumbled to Gate City 4-yard line with 2:03 to go, and the Blue Devils able to get one first down and run out the clock.
Well, I went over and took a look at the stats that Sullivan South keeps electronically. Sullivan South had exactly 500 yards of total offense in this game.
Golly.
We had 384. Joseph Vaughn ran for 214 yards tonight. So, I'll tell you one thing. You don't give up 500 yards very often to win.
No. Yeah, and the Gate City team don't give up 500 yards, period.
But you know, Sam, it last year we turned the ball over and they beat us. And in the end tonight, they turned the ball over at the five-yard line and probably
– good point.
You know, sealed the victory for us. So, yep. You know, we were good hosts to them last year. They were good hosts to us this year. And the series is even at 1-1, and hopefully the series will keep going. We'll find that out, I guess, going later on. But, again, big, huge victory tonight. But got to get started next week now. Clinch Mountain District play, Larry. Lebanon comes to town. Lebanon comes back and defeats Tazewell tonight, 31-24. And they'll be coming to our house, the place that they admit they don't like to come to.
Right.
And
well, we don't like them to come, Murray.
And we want to send them back with a loss. And, I think we come out of this tonight pretty healthy, other than there's going to be a lot of people not doing much dancing tomorrow with all the cramps and stuff that we suffered through tonight. But,
right.
You know, hopefully we pretty much kept everybody on the healthy side, and we'll get ready to open the Clinch Mountain District season on Legion Field next Friday night. So we'll wrap it up from here at Death Valley and Kingsport at Sullivan South. We'll tell you again the final score. It's a Gate City Blue Devils 31 and the Sullivan South Rebels 28. For Tim Hill on the coach's camera, for Jim Benton, Larry Sheehan. I want to try.